Hello students, today I am going to discuss biography of Robert Herrick. Robert Herrick was a 17th century English lyric poet and cleric. Cleric means priest. He was a poet of Caroline age. Caroline age means the age of Charles I. Caroline being the adjective of Carolus, the Latin word for Charles, so that's why this age is called Caroline age. Charles was executed in 1649 in civil war. So this period is extended to 1660, the year of his son Charles II's return to the throne. So that's why this Caroline age is from 1625 to 1660. He was a great cavalier poet. Cavalier poets were largely court poets who wrote poetry reflecting gaiety and easygoing life. Cavalier poets, being the follower of Ben Jonson, they were also called tribes of Ben. Herrick was also follower of Ben Jonson, so he dedicated his 5 poems to Ben Jonson. Robert Herrick was a supporter of King in his struggle with the Parliament during Civil War. That's why the bulk of his poetry was written under the influence of the court. He was also a clergyman and lover of countryside. He wrote religious and nature poetry. His collection of verse is Hesperides, which contains a religious section called Noble Numbers. Hesperides contains such immortal lyrics on love and nature as to the virgins, to make much of time, to daffodils, to blossom. So these are very famous poems of Robert Herrick. The overriding message of Herrick's work is that life is short, the world is beautiful, love is splendid, and we must use the short time we have to make the most of it. And the recurring theme of his love poem is seize the day, for tomorrow we die. Seize the day means hold, catch. Catch the day means enjoy the day, because tomorrow we will die. So he writes in one of his poems, gather ye rosebuds while ye may. So you enjoy your day. And that of nature poems, theme of nature poem is how soon things have their end. And these themes can be clearly seen in To the Virgins, to make much of time, to daffodils, to blossoms. His poems were not very popular at the time they were published. His style was strongly influenced by Ben Jonson, by classical Roman writers, and by the poems of late Elizabethan era. This must have been quite old-fashioned to an audience whose tastes were tuned to the complexity of metaphysical poets such as John Donne and Andrew Marvel. So his poems were not read during his time, but his works were rediscovered in the early 19th century and have been regularly printed ever since. So they are being read. Victorian poet Swinburne described Herrick as the greatest songwriter ever born of English race. So during 19th century, he was described as the greatest songwriter. Despite his use of classical allusions and names, Herrick poems are easier for modern readers to understand than those of many of his contemporaries. Thank you very much. In the next video, I will discuss the poem To Daffodil.